Hey, hey, and welcome back to Your Biz, Your Rules. Now, today, I want to talk to you about boundaries. I actually had something completely different planned for today's episode, but the theme of boundaries and creating these really strong, robust boundaries has been popping up quite a lot recently and quite a few conversations I've been having with different people. So I thought, let's dig into that. Let's look at how you can create boundaries in a way that really like safeguards your sanity, your time, your energy, and also your client relationships, because those are important too. And I think that's a really good place to start, because often you sort of feel like if you have these boundaries and you stick to them, it makes you look like a dick. It makes you look like you're not there to support and delight your clients in every possible way. And to a certain extent, that's true, because you are not there to babysit them. You're not there to do everything for them. You're there to provide a specific service, and you cannot provide that service to the best of your ability if you are also doing all of this other stuff that's not really in your wheelhouse. So that's why we have these boundaries. From a client perspective, from a self perspective, we have them so that we can actually live our lives and enjoy our lives and not sit there all night or all weekend worrying that we haven't done a certain thing, or worrying about the state of our inbox when we get back to it on a Monday morning and all of that stuff. Like, we run our businesses because we want to have more control over how we feel and how we live, and that's just not going to happen if you constantly let people overstep, and if you train them to overstep by just, you know, indulging it. We've got to be hard, we've got to be strict with these people. And that includes yourself, it really does. So I'm going to run through a few different areas where you can just start to think about having, I would say, stronger guidelines over the way you'll behave and the way you'll allow yourself to be treated. And then we might brainstorm a few ways that you can make those work in reality. So the first and like most obvious thing, but often the thing that people forget about, is your working hours. So your working hours do not have to subscribe to this 9-to-5 model that perhaps they would if you had a corporate career, but they can if you want them to. So what I would suggest is look at how you want your week to be. Look at what hours you want to be working every day, ideally. Just let yourself imagine this, like, in the ideal world, how much time would you be spending working, and what hours of the day would you be spending working? And just write that down. Include breaks in that, because you need to break up that focus time and rejuvenate yourself. You need to eat proper meals. You need to like stand up from your desk chair and walk around the room. So just brain dump on a page the way that your days would be structured in an ideal world. So what time would you start? What time would you finish? What time would you take a break? What time would you have your lunch? What time would you walk your dog? All of that stuff. I mean, you might also want to think about what time you'll set aside to work on your own business stuff. So on any like admin that you have, any business development, your own digital content, all of that jazz. Because you need to schedule that in somewhere, because if you don't schedule it, it's never going to happen, and all of this stuff is just going to get on top of you. So that's another important reason that we have these specific timelines and boundaries in place. So the next thing is to think about what you actually do for your clients, the services you provide, project scopes, specific deliverables. Like, what is your zone of genius? Why are they hiring you? And what things aren't quite in your remit. Now, this isn't a case of not wanting to muck in. It is not a case of being like, oh, that's not in my job description. It's not that. It's making sure that you have the time, the headspace, the energy to provide the thing that they're paying for. As an example, I create a lot of written content for people, right? And I have a specific amount of time set aside for certain clients. And in that time, I create this content. But if those same clients want me to keep testing links and testing the look of different pages they're doing and testing workflows and stuff like that, which they could be asking their tech VA to do, I'm not going to have the same amount of time to create their digital content. And that, like, that boundary is a very rigid one that I have to keep in place. So I'm happy to do anything that they want me to do, but as long as they're aware that that means I will be creating less of the digital content. And because the content is the stuff they're paying me for, they're all very understanding about it. And it's very clear and very easy that the other stuff is what they should be asking somebody else to do. So think about how that kind of structure and that kind of clarity can help you with your own stuff. So and I mean, for goodness sake, have all of this stuff in your client agreements. You should know what you're providing while you're working with someone. You should know that if you're on a retainer, what you're providing with them each month, whether that's specific deliverables or an amount of time or whatever. You need to be clear on that, because you cannot plan and you cannot manage people's expectations if you don't have that stuff clear. The third area that we're going to look at, and this is an uncomfortable one for everybody, but price. Pricing. I've never met somebody who has this stuff all worked out and working seamlessly, because it can be uncomfortable, it really can. But I want you to, like, write on an index card and stick it above your desk saying, and like, just write, there is no wiggle room on my pricing. There is no wiggle room on my pricing. That is so important, because as soon as somebody tries to barter you down and offer you less money for this amazing service that you're doing, you instantly are going to feel undervalued and you're going to be less invested in doing an amazing job for them. So what I would suggest, and what I do, if somebody doesn't have the budget for a certain package, look at ways that you can decrease the package in order to make it fit their budget. Don't just say, okay, yeah, I'll give you this massive discount and still offer you all of the same stuff. Because that's you undervaluing your own work. And that's something that should never happen. If one person is going to believe in the quality of what you do, it should be you. The fourth point I want to bring to your attention, and this is something that has honestly made the biggest difference to my own sanity, is how you're willing to be contacted. So some people I've worked with in the past have a rule about, so they'll only be contacted via email and only one email a day. Some people might choose to only be contacted by WhatsApp or only by Slack. That's going to be different depending on how you like to communicate, how often you need to communicate, and all of that stuff. Some people might like a weekly call, some people never want to go on a call, so that will depend on your personal tastes. But my rules around this are things like, don't ever phone me, because Jesus Christ, I will not answer. I will look at my phone with suspicion and wonder why people are ringing me. I pretty much do that even when my family phones, so clients, nah. Another thing is, don't contact me via Facebook Messenger. That's not a work platform. It's not an easy to search through platform. It's not easy to share files. And sometimes Facebook has these glitches where it shares files that you've shared in Messenger to your wall. And yeah, I just don't like that at all. So be really specific about how and when you can be contacted. And again, this goes back to your work hours. Like, be realistic about how often you will respond to emails, like what kind of turnaround time they can expect, all of that stuff. You want to outline as specifically as possible, and you don't have to show everybody the nitty-gritty, but you have to be clear in your own mind what's okay and what's not okay, because otherwise you're not going to get closer to this ideal life and business that you've been dreaming of. So the fifth area that I want you to think about is the timeline of your work. So how much notice do you need in between somebody giving you a brief and you completing a task? Like, how soon do you need to receive information from them? Be really anal about all of the parameters that relate to time of your different work tasks. And again, this is not something you have to share with everybody, but just have it clear in your head and never be one of those people that's like, yes, I'll do that now. Yes, I'll do that now. Yes, I'll do that now for every single thing. If it is coming to the end of your workday and someone hits you with a can you just, the answer is no, because it's coming to the end of your workday. Nobody is going to sack you for saying, I'm about to close up for the day, I'll look at this view tomorrow, or I'm out for the afternoon, I'll look at this view on Monday. Like, nobody is going to hate you because of that. And you need to get out of this mindset that people will hate you just because you are sort of the boss of your own business and you're being strong and you're being assertive. And I mean, it's easy for me to say this, but I struggle with this a lot. If I receive any kind of message from one of my clients, even if it's like a positive thing, I'll be looking for subtext that they hate me. I really will. And it's just one of those things that we have to keep working on, and the boundaries will help. The boundaries, they don't just help you stay sane. They really help manage expectations for everybody. So your clients know what's expected of them and they know what to expect of you. And it just leads to a generally more positive working relationship for everybody. And I want you to remember that these boundaries don't necessarily have to be just for your clients. They could be for your team. They could be for your friends and family. I mean, how many times, just because you work from home, have you been expected to wait in for deliveries or deal with like house admin or childcare or any of that stuff simply because you work at home? And that's not acceptable, because this is a business. You have to be able to keep those boundaries in place at home as well, and you can only do that when you know what they are. So really take some time to, like I said, dream up your ideal looking day or your ideal looking week and think about what boundaries would need to be in place to make sure that would happen. Now, once you've done the dreaming part, once you've done the journaling, the brainstorming, all of that good stuff, condense that so it's easily accessible for your people. Make sure that the boundaries that relate to the different groups of people in your life are all in one place and clear. And just email them. You can just be like, hi guys, I've been working on my boundaries. This is what I've come up with. I just want to like make it all clear so we're all on the same page and everyone is happy at the end of the day. And list out all of this stuff. I mean, it doesn't have to be a whole big thing. It doesn't have to involve a whole new contract. Just be really personable and really informal and just get it out there so that they're aware. The biggest challenge really is not telling other people your boundaries. The biggest challenge is sticking to it yourself. So if you're like, right, I am not going to email people in the evenings, don't email me in the evenings, don't email me at the weekends, blah, blah, blah. But then you go on and check your emails and you respond to emails on a Sunday afternoon. I mean, that's training people to ignore what you said, to ignore your boundaries, to encroach on your personal time. And you've already said that's not what you want, so you stick to those rules too. Now, with emails in particular, if you really feel like you need to have that extra time over the weekend or in the evening to wade through your inbox, use a tool like Boomerang. Now, Boomerang is a free add-on for Gmail that allows you to draft your emails and schedule them to be sent at a later date, which is really, really handy, because then you can sort of respond to all of these emails on a Sunday afternoon, but have them actually get sent when it's back during working hours. So that's my little trick of the day for emails. Another little tip of mine, because I know how uncomfortable these conversations can feel, even if they're fine once they've happened, like leading up to a discussion about boundaries with a client can just feel really horrible and really uncomfortable. So what you can do is prepare yourself a little set of scripts that you can use. So if somebody does encroach on your boundaries in different ways, you've got a little template that you can just whip out, tweak, and respond to them with, without having to like undergo some serious emotional trauma just thinking about it. I think the biggest thing that you can really do is just be transparent, be honest, not just with people but with yourself. You need to know what you want and you need to think up the ways that are going to help you achieve that. and then make them happen, put them out there, share them with the world, like make it a core part of your client agreements and have it in your autoresponders, all of that stuff. So you are slowly but surely training the people in your life to respect these edges that you've built for yourself. Because so when you have these edges and you have these structures in place, that's when you can truly flourish and start enjoying life and enjoying your business. That's all there is to it. So your job for today is go and have a think, dream up that ideal week, like I said, outline your own boundaries and make them happen. Thank you for listening to Your Biz, Your Rules. I hope you enjoyed listening to this episode as much as I enjoyed creating it. If you'd like to learn a little bit more about weaving personality into your business, please feel free to hop over to my website, darapaddy.com. That's where you'll find all kinds of resources and all kinds of inspiration for just being a little bit more you online, because it is possible.